Okay, so I show you how to do different things every week in Todoist. Well, this week I'm going to show you how I have my Todoist set up in late 2019. Hello and welcome to another episode of my Working with Todoist series. My name is Carl Pullein, and in this week's episode I am going to take you into my own real Todoist account and show you how I have it set up. As I always do every year since I started this YouTube channel, we do an early and a late setup because most people's to-do list managers, and I guess pretty much everybody's to-do list managers, are constantly evolving, and mine is too, and I have new ideas that I try out. Some things work, some things don't work, so I like to keep you up to date just to throw out some ideas to you guys to see if something might work for you. Now, before I go into and show you my Todoist, I would like to stress that this setup basically works for me. It doesn't mean that it will work for you. The key to developing a great productivity system is to build a system around the way that you work and the way that you think. So please, please do not copy my system, but by all means, take anything you wish from my system that may help enhance your very own system. Okay, before I too take you into Todoist, I would just like to say, if you do get any value from this episode, then please help me in return and hit that like button below. And if you haven't subscribed to my channel yet and you would like to get all the latest tips, news and views about Todoist, then please subscribe to my channel. Okay, it is now time for me to take you into my Todoist, my real account, and show you how I have it set up. Okay, so let's get started with my late 2019 Todoist setup. Now, there have been a number of changes this year, so we're going to get started. Now, for those of you who watch my Todoist series every week, you will know all about my purpose and objectives project. And that essentially is basically all the things that I am planning on doing this week, next week, and everything else. So you can see that in here, I have my purpose and objective the mission statement, if you like: wake up with energy, have purpose for the day, and stay focused on achieving it. I've got my this week's focus. So these are the things that I'm focused on this week. My 2020 planning is in there. It has been there for quite some time because we're now getting close to where I'm going to set everything out. That's probably going to be there for the rest of this year. And then I've got my week. Now, this is my genuine account. This is not my demo account at all. So this is everything that I am doing this week. And of course, down below, which is a bit more secret, is my month's objectives. But there you go, you can see my real objectives right now as things are showing up here. So that's my purpose and objectives. And this is, if you like, my purpose and objectives dashboard. I look at this every single day. Now, in the past, I did have something similar in my areas of focus, and this is actually in my areas, which I'll show you in a moment, of mastery. But what this does is this keeps me really hyper-focused on the things that are truly important to me. So there you go. That's one of the big changes for this year, that's coming this year. Now, the way I've set up my filters, or if you like, my workflow down here, I've got my today's objectives, my today's focus, and my next actions. These have not changed. Neither has the golden 10. That has not changed from earlier this year when I did my early 2019 setup. So let's go into my projects now. And in my projects here, I've now changed this around a little bit. Now, I have a number of active projects, and these are all now as one. I used to separate these out as something to do with work and personal, but I realized that a project is a project is a project. So I'm just keeping everything into what I call my active projects. So these are the things that I am currently working on right now. Now, for those of you who recently done my Create Your Own Apple productivity system. This was an active project while I was doing it, and there's one more task to do which will be done in the early December. So anyone watching this, by the way, I have been asked about this. Will I be updating the Skillshare version of the Create Your Own Apples course? The answer is yes, I will, and I'm going to be doing that early December. So it depends when you're watching this, but if you're watching this in, say, mid to late December, it should already have been updated. So that's an active project. Once that task has been done, as you can see, I've actually dated this one. It's also flagged as a blue flag, which means it's going to be done on the 7th of December in the afternoon. I can tell you that right now. So yes, it's going to be done. I've also got to to-do list. I've got to update the beginner's Todoist course. Again, I'm going to try and get that done before I go on my Christmas holiday. I have a workshop. This is actually a webinar that I'm going to be doing in the near future. I've also got the Life and Time Mastery workshop, which is on the 28th of December, if I remember correctly, in Scunthorpe in the United Kingdom. So if you want to join us, tickets are available. I will put a link to that in the show notes. Ireland 2019-2020, that's because I'm going there for my Christmas holiday with my to visit my family. So these are all what I could describe as active projects. They are projects that I am currently working on, and hopefully I'll get all of these finished, I hope, by the end of the year. So that's one of the first things. I've decided to consolidate all my active projects, projects that I'm working on at this moment in time, into one folder. Because really, a project is a project. It doesn't matter whether it's professional or personal. The only difference what I do is red means work and blue means personal. So there you go. Now, moving back, I've got my tickler file, which has not changed at all. Single actions have not changed at all. Again, except what I may have done, I should have checked actually, but I have now again consolidated single actions into just one project. My routines have not changed. They're still the same. They are all back there. And my areas of focus. Now, my areas of focus, as you can see down here, again, what I've done is I've decided, and this is one of the big changes, and really it's more of an experiment, that my areas of focus means my professional life. So these are the things that I want to focus on from a professional perspective. So CPP is my productivity business. I'm a coach, I write, I'm a teacher, I'm a speaker, I do online courses, as you know, podcasts, YouTube channels, social media, marketing, sales, and website. So all these are in together, and they're all categorized under orange, just to make things just a little bit cleaner. So really that hasn't changed, except that I've taken out the personal areas and I've moved them into a new area called areas of mastery. Now, areas of mastery essentially is something that I picked up at Tony Robbins's Unleash the Power Within course. These are the seven areas of life. Well, actually, it's eight here, but the seven areas of life are built on your physical health, your emotional and meaning health, your family and relationships, the time, your purpose and mission, your finances, and your contribution and spirituality. This is like a pyramid, and any of you who've done the Unleash the Power Within seminar, you will know all about this. The only addition I have there is my purpose and objectives, which is what I showed you earlier, which is pinned up at the top there. I've added that because this is, I see that as an area of mastery. If I can master my time, which is this one here, that is going to help me with my purpose and objectives. Now, I should point out that this is work in progress. This is something new. I only started in September. I've not completely filled it out yet, but as I do my planning for 2020, I anticipate that this will fill up over the next few weeks, actually, because we've only got a few weeks to the end of the year. So areas of mastery for me is more to do with my personal life, me as a person. My areas of focus are more professional work, work that I'm doing on a professional level. It might seem confusing at the moment, and it's not absolutely crystal clear to me yet, but it's something that I really want to make it work, because I was inspired by what I learned to Unleash the Power Within, and I think this is something that's going to really help me to develop as a person over the future years to come. And finally, I have my someday maybe, which again has not changed at all, because it's just the same as it was before, and my filters essentially are dominated by my workflow, which is down here. So essentially that's is how my Todoist is operating now. So things come through on a daily basis. Now, throughout the year, I have pointed out that I generally don't date anything that's further away than a week, unless I know exactly when I'm going to do it. So for example, uploading the Apple productivity course to Skillshare, I already know that I'm going to do it on Saturday the 7th. I just know that. But generally speaking, I wouldn't date anything that goes beyond a week, i.e. basically up to the next weekly review. And it's the weekly review I do religiously every Sunday, so I know that I will always be on top of what I can do, and I use that with my calendar. So there you go. That is my Todoist setup. Late 2019, I will put a link in the show notes to my early 2019 setup so you can do a comparison if you wish. I know I'm probably going to get a lot of questions about the areas of mastery. I have done a video on this. It is very much a work in progress. It might be something that I will eventually remove just in the interest of simplicity. But for now, I really want to see if I can make it work. So that's a bit of an experiment. Okay. Hopefully this has helped you some ideas about how you may wish to set up your own Todoist. But please remember, copying somebody else's system isn't necessarily going to work for you. I show you this just to give you some ideas about how you can use your own or set up your own Todoist. And hopefully it will give you a lot of ideas going forward into 2020. Well, thank you very much for watching this episode. It just remains for me now to wish you all a very, very productive week. Thank you very much for watching this video. Now, have I got something special to tell you about? The Time and Life Mastery version 3 course has launched. Now, this course is transformative. It will transform your life. If you find that your life is drifting from one day to the next and that you feel that you're not actually achieving your goals, then this course is going to show you how to change that. It's going to show you how to identify what is truly important to you. It's going to show you how to find what it is you want out of life, and then show you the steps that you need to take in order to get there. This course is amazing. The feedback I've got from versions 1 and version 2 have just been tremendous. It has helped so many people, and I want this opportunity to tell you that it can do the same for you. I hope you will take a look at the course, have a go, take the course, and start transforming your life today. This course will do that for you. Take a look, get yourself enrolled, and hopefully I'll see you in the course.